context matters, and we're exclusively focused within a professional context. That's what we do, and that's always been the case since the company was founded. I think that is the reason for a few different explanations. I think, for starters, just by focusing on professional context, you get a clearer signal. In a world where it's so easy to share, where there's so little friction in terms of the sharing of information, knowledge, ideas, and opinions, people are increasingly overwhelmed. And when you can frame information in a specific context, in our case, professional orientation, it becomes more relevant and more valuable. And I think, separate apart from that, you know, there's I think, fairly obvious reasons some people want to keep their personal lives separate from their professional lives. And we hear that from members regardless of culture, country, around the world.
Yeah, to add in brief form, it's why do you need an office when you have a house? Or why do you need a suit when you have sweat clothes?
That's it, huh?
Yeah, that would be the the simplest way of putting it.
Okay, the IPO phenomenon. It's the stock after opening and then going crazy. Why did it go crazy?
Well, I think that there's, I'm not really an expert on public market and valuations, but I think there's a lot of demand for growth.
Yeah.
And so people are interested in things that they anticipate are building the future.
Right.
And so, you know, and the tech IPO markets have been closed for a while. I mean, I think when we went out, I think it was one of the times where people were looking for more tech IPOs.
Right.
And so all of that kind of combined for a lot of interest, a lot of attention, and a lot of excitement. The vagaries of it going up and then coming down some and then going back up, I think in 3 to 5 year plans rather than.
How often do you watch it? Do you look at it every hour, every day, every?
Let's see. Since we've gone out, which was May, I've looked it up 5 times.
Is that right? Are you serious?
Yes, totally.
I know people that run media companies look at it every 30 minutes.
When you're serious about investing on a 3 to 5 year time frame and what you're building in the future, this week, this month, you know, you pay some attention to it, but it doesn't. What matters a year from now.
Where do you come down on this idea that there is a bubble around the corner? And this was a glimmer of what might be.
Yeah, I think it's important to draw a distinction between what happened in the late 90s and what's happening now. And you're always going to be able to find isolated cases where there's going to be overvaluation. But if you look at the category leaders, certainly with regard to the consumer web in the late 90s, I think things certainly started to get ahead of themselves. And at that time, I think companies were going public for the sake of going public, not for the sake of generating the right kind of investment, strengthening their balance sheet for longer-term investment purposes. I think today you look at category leaders like a Facebook, Zynga, LinkedIn, Groupon, and I think these companies have clearly sustainable value propositions that can massively scale. They have more predictable top line and, in certain cases, bottom line in terms of cash flow generation. Their business models are more predictable. So I think there are some clear distinctions.
Okay.
I would just add that the only time where it really turns out to be a bubble is if, in fact, the growth that everyone feels is present isn't realized. So
right.
It's kind of it's a guess as to what the future looks like. And I think actually to amplify what Jeff's saying is I think a lot of these companies actually have much more interesting fundamentals
I think that's the essential difference, don't you?
I
mean, there is no sort of understandable, reliable earnings stream in certain cases in 2001 that you can see in companies today.
Yep.
Join us online at charlierose.com.